Hello, hello and welcome. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on the Series X for the signal update. Yep, it's out. It came out yesterday. And with it, a great DLC pack with lots of cool stuff. And the signal update itself has expanded the way that we can communicate via grids. So this was going to be all about wind turbines, wind clearance and power, but because of signal I've changed things up, and we are now going to take a quick look at a couple of the new blocks that came in signal. I will be doing a more in-depth video on the whole signal update and the signal DLC, so you can see what blocks you're getting for your money and what you can do with them and how cool they look. I've already got a couple of ideas for various things with the DLC. But to get started, we're going to need a couple of grids. So we're just going to press in the left stick in creative mode. We're just going to grab our light armor block. And if the armor block is sticking up like this, just hold down the left bumper and tap RT till it sinks into the ground, and then we're just going to build a small grid of blocks, and we're going to build another small grid of blocks. Let's extend it one more, and we're going to have our little grid here. And what we're going to do is we're just going to pop down a control station on this one and a battery on both because we need power, and these grids are separate, so there's no possible communication between these two grids at this point in time. So let's set up an antenna, and we're going to go for the new cool compact antenna on both. Actually, make it easier on myself so I can just boop up like that. So on the second grid, we're just going to pop in a block. It's my favourite block. Under lights, I'm going to go for the inset light block. I love this light block. We're just going to use the battery here and turn the light off. And so now, the first block that I want to talk about is our new block found hiding away in advanced systems, and it's our little block here, action relay. We're going to need one on this grid, and we're going to need one on this grid. And on this grid, if we come into the control panel of the action relay and we take a look at it, we want each channel to be one, accept a signal from the faction, and we want it to do nothing. That's our one that is going to communicate. In fact, let me just look. Yeah, that'll work. So we want to come over to our second action relay, and we are going to look at its channel at one, and then we're going to set up its actions. And as you can see, we've got pages just like on the event controller and on timer blocks and so on, so we can swap pages. But we want this block here. We want the inset light and we want it toggle on off. And then we come over to our little control station, jump into the seat, hold down the D-pad in the chosen direction, in my case up, choose the action relay and tell it to send a signal. And then when we push up on the D-pad, the light comes on and the light goes off. Light comes on, light goes off, light comes on, light goes off. And that is how you use the action relay between two grids. And whatever channel that second relay is on is the receiver channel. So if it's on one, then any signal sent on channel one will trigger it. If it's on channel two, and so on. So if you've got multiple relays on the same grid, you can have multiple actions triggered via multiple relays on different channels. And so that's a basic example of using the action relay to turn a light on and off. And it can control different blocks. So one great thing is you can have a ship that can have an action relay on it. And that ship can send a signal to another action relay, which will then perform the chosen action, be it turning lights on and off, or in our case, we could have hangar doors which can be remotely controlled by our little arriving ship. So we have the ship arrive, trigger the door to open and close. That's fairly simple to demonstrate. We'll just basically put our blocks down like this. And then we'll find our airtight hangar doors. We'll use these, an old favourite. We'll grab a bunch. We'll come across to our action relay. We'll hold down the right bumper. Select the first hangar door and then keep pushing down on the D-pad and tapping A on each one. Use the left stick, move across the block group. Just name it something like this. Save it off. Come back across with the left stick. Click A on the action relay. This time, set up actions and we'll have it so that the light triggers at the same time as the door. So we just go to the group, choose open and closed, like so. Come out. Remember, we should still have the signal transmitted from one to the other. And there you go. Light comes on, doors change the state, light goes off, doors are opening, and once more. And that's the action relay. And this will allow grids to communicate over long distances. Plus, if you use laser antennas, you can increase that distance even further. And you could make entire sensor satellite arrays that detect players sending signals back to a comms hub, which then reroutes that signal down to a main base and alerts the engineers there, or even activates some form of defense system that you've got, launching defensive drones maybe. This action relay really opens up a lot of interesting options that we've only just started to look at. But I wanted to get this little basic video up just to show you how to use the new blocks. And the next new block is this broadcast controller. Let's get it up the right way. There it is. So this lets a grid send a message, as long as you have an antenna on the grid. If you don't use an antenna, then the grid itself will send a message to the cockpit. So if I unclick use antenna and I pick message one as hello, I like that, YouTubes. Hello, YouTubes. So, hello, YouTube. And so on. If I now jump into this grid, hold down on the D-pad, choose my broadcast controller, and tell it to transmit message one. When I tap down on the D-pad, you'll see hello, YouTube appears on the left-hand side. So now we can also use this comms block here on this grid over here. So let's just pop another broadcast controller over here, but this time we're going to turn it the right way up, have a sensor. So we set up our broadcast controller to use an antenna, and message one in here, like so. And if you fill all the messages in, you can actually have it send a random message. Then we go to our little sensor, just set that up briefly on set up actions, change nothing else, and we'll go broadcast controller, transmit message one. Leave it at that. And there you go. So when it detects that I'm in the sensor field, it sends, hey-o! So you can actually have drones with sensors detecting all sorts of things, sending messages back to players, to your faction, and so on. It's just the tip of the iceberg with signal. But that's what I wanted to do today. I just wanted to show you those two blocks, the action relay and the broadcast control block. This is a great little block, which is going to be a lot of fun to play around with. And I'm sure a bunch of you will already come up with some creative, interesting uses for the blocks. I mean, for instance, in the past, we've taken the custom turret controller, and instead of turrets, you can actually use the custom turret controller to control the position for drilling using the right stick of a drill arm. And I'm using the automaton's camera because it allows you to place cameras in areas where you normally wouldn't be able to get them, like here, pointing straight down. But yeah, so you can use this system to enable remote communications between two grids. And we will be experimenting. I will be experimenting with various things to see what fun stuff I can do. But until then, stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy the game, enjoy the signal update. And I will be back with a bigger, more in-depth look at signal, because signal changes a few things and it also adds new functionality, new blocks, and some surprises into the game. It's like a mid-game refresh. We've got a new screen. We've got a new version of Red Ship, which I will be going through as well as part of the Signal update video, because the new version of the Red Ship map is absolutely brilliant. It's a completely different version to the old one, with far more functionality and far more interesting design. Until then, though, keep watching for updates for Space Engineers, because it's going to get bigger, it's going to get better, and from the tease that they posted as part of the blog, we've got some big things incoming. That's all from me, though. Bye for now.